This lecture is going to be about phases of a wave. These two waves have the exact same wavelength, period, frequency, amplitude, and velocity, but they still look different from each other. We need one more vocab word to describe the physical difference between two waves. So the reason why we do physics is to describe and understand the world, and if there's a part of the world that we don't have vocabulary for, like the difference between these two waves, we need to invent a new vocabulary term to describe it. Before we talk about this difference, we need to make an observation about the shape of a wave. Any wave graph can be understood as the graph of the vertical height of the radius line of a circle on the y-axis and the angle of the vector on the x-axis. So as this circle goes around, you'll notice that if we track just the vertical height of that radius line as it goes around a circle, that produces a wave. So all waves actually share this property, where they can be understood as the vertical height of that radius line on the y-axis and the degree of the circle on the x-axis. So each of these graphs can show the y-axis height of the radius line for every angle around the circle. So I'm just going to make a graph of the vertical height of the radius line as it goes around the circle, and the x-axis again will have those angles on it in both degrees and radians. What I'm trying to get across here is that certain angles can be associated with certain parts of a wave, and the change in an angle by a certain amount corresponds to the change in a wave by a certain amount. The specific angle that we start from in the circle is kind of arbitrary. We could also make wave graphs that look like this, just starting from different angles around the circle. And that still produces the same pattern. So the specific angle that a wave is at different points isn't really a constant, but there's something that is constant in the shape of a wave. So the thing that's not arbitrary about the relationship between the angle and the wave is what fraction of the wave a change in angle produces. For example, if we graph the full wave using that circle, no matter which part of the wave we're looking at, a 90 degree or pi over 2 radian change in the circle results in a change of 1/4 of the wave. 180 degrees goes with half the wave. 270 goes with 3/4 of the wave. And 360 goes with the full wave. We can now understand specific fractions of a wave as being equal to specific angles over the full wave. We can use this new way of recording the fraction of a wave to describe how two waves that are otherwise completely alike are at different points in their motion. This is called the phase difference between two waves. This is the difference between which part of the wave's full period or wavelength each wave is on, expressed as the angle difference between the two. Waves at the same point on their wavelength or frequency are said to be in phase. So there's no phase difference between two waves that are perfectly alike. So as an example, I can see that the bottom wave is exactly the same as the top wave. It's just shifted by 1/4 of its length. So that means that the phase difference is going to be 1/4 times 360 degrees, or 2 pi. So the phase difference is equal to 90 degrees, or pi over 2. So I would describe the bottom wave as having a phase difference of 90 degrees, or pi over 2, from the top wave. Here I can see that the wave is shifted by this much, which is 5/8 of the wave, using that bottom equation for phase difference. 5/8 times 360, or 2 pi, gets me a phase difference of 225 degrees, or 5 pi over 4. This is a displacement time graph, but the exact same rule still works for finding the phase difference. I just need to compare the difference in the waves. And I can see that this is a difference in 7/8 of the wave. So to find the phase difference, I just multiply 7/8 by 360, or 2 pi. And that gets me a phase difference of 315 degrees, or 7 pi over 4. Simple harmonic motion can also be described with phase differences because it can be graphed with the shape of a wave. For example, in this picture, that bottom portion of simple harmonic motion is 3/8 along its full path compared to the original point at that one maximum point of compression. So what's happened here is that that spring that oscillates has been released from rest, moves through the equilibrium position, and continues to move between the equilibrium position and the other maximum. So at that point, it's gone along 3/8 of its full oscillation because it has to come all the way back to that other max for it to be a full oscillation. So because this is 3/8 of its full oscillation, we would say that the phase difference is 3/8 times 360 degrees, which is equal to a 135 degree phase difference, or a 3π/4 phase difference. If it's going backwards, that means that it's already achieved that maximum and is moving back in the opposite direction. So that means that it has now covered 5/8 of its total motion. So the phase difference there would be 225 degrees, or 5π/4. Just one last note, a negative phase difference just means a shift to the left on the graph rather than to the right. So here this graph has been shifted by 1/4 of its period to the left. So that means the fraction of the wave that's been shifted is negative 1/4. So the phase difference is negative 90 degrees, or negative π/2.